Welcome to Swaraj Sweet Delights. Today we are going to make pineapple pastry cake, and that too eggless and without oven. And this is kids special, so I am going to show you Doraemon cake which we are making in pineapple flavor. So let's see how to make it.
Let's see the ingredients. We will need 200 grams of maida or all-purpose flour. Then here is condensed milk, 1 cup. Here is melted butter, 1/2 cup, and I have taken salted butter. If you are using unsalted butter, you need to add 1/4 teaspoon of salt. And here is pineapple extract or pineapple essence, 2 teaspoons. Here is baking powder, 2 teaspoons, and baking soda, 1 teaspoon. And here we have drinking soda, and will require 1 cup of drinking soda. Let's see the ingredients. We will require whipping cream. This is heavy whipping cream and I have whipped it. It is chilled. And for the recipe, you can watch my previous video or the link in the description box below. And here is sugar water solution. I have taken here 1/2 cup sugar and 1 cup of water, and I have just boiled till the sugar dissolves. Here is some pineapple crush. And you can also make use of pineapple pieces, but this is readily available everywhere, the crush. These are few colors, and this is dark chocolate ganache, and this is the thick one. For this I have used 2 cups of chopped dark chocolate and 1 cup of fresh cream. And for the chocolate ganache recipe, you can watch my previous video. And this is the thick one. After the ganache cools completely for 10 to 12 hours, you will get this consistency, the thicker one. To a sieve, we added our all-purpose flour, and in goes baking powder and baking soda. And we are going to sift this 3 times. We sifted our flour, and now we are going to keep this aside. Those who have seen my previous videos, they all know very well that I do ovenless baking, and I normally bake in this aluminium vessel. This is a big aluminium vessel, and inside I have placed one stand or ring. And I've closed the lid, and we are going to preheat this for 10-15 minutes. Now to a mixing bowl, we are going to add condensed milk. And melted butter. Also, we will add pineapple essence. And we are going to whisk this all together. You can see here our butter and condensed milk are well incorporated, and now it's time to add some dry flour. Add in batches. We'll just fold in. You can see here our mixture is very dry, and now to this we will add 1 cup of drinking soda. And again we are going to mix our batter. Just mix it gently. Right now we added 1/2 cup. I am going to add more 1/2 cup to this. After adding soda, you will get a frothy mixture like this, but don't worry. It is only the reaction of the soda. And now we will mix this into a smooth batter. Just don't whisk it. Just fold it gently and make smooth batter, and just try to break the lumps. You can see here our batter is ready. And now we will just pour it into our cake tin. Here I have taken cake tin and I have greased it with little butter, and now I am going to pour this batter into this cake tin. You can see here we have poured the batter in the cake tin, and here I have taken one big cake tin. Now we are just going to give a gentle tap, and then we are going to place this into our vessel. You can see I have placed my cake tin inside the vessel, and now we will cover this and we will bake it on very low flame for 30 minutes. And after 30 minutes we are going to check. You can see here it's been 30 minutes, and now we will just insert a skewer. And you can see our skewer has come out clean, and we have also got a nice brown shade. at the edges and our cake is baked properly. Now we'll just take out the tin and we will let it cool for some time before unmolding. Our cake is cooled properly and now we will just loosen it from the sides and we will unmold our cake. Gently we will just lift our cake tin. You can see so beautifully our cake has risen and it's quite soft and spongy. You can see. And now we will let it cool for more 10 minutes and then we will start icing. We will cut slices out of this. Now we are going to slice our cake into 2 or 3 parts, whichever you feel like. We have to make a sandwich cut and I have this serrated knife here and I'm just going to mark first and then I'm going to cut slices. Now gently we will cut our first layer. You can see here we have taken out the topmost layer and again we will cut 2 more layers from this, 2 to 3 more layers from this, and you can see the texture of the cake, how crumbly it is, and it's quite soft and spongy. You can see here all our layers are ready and now we will start assembling our cake. You can see here this is a cake board and on this cake board I'm just going to apply some fresh cream so that our cake will stick to it properly. Now on this we are going to place our last layer of cake. Now to this layer we are just going to soak it with little sugar and water syrup, just little, so that the cake will be moist enough. Now we are going to add some crush, pineapple crush, and we are just going to spread it evenly. After crush, now we are going to add our cream to this. Apply a thin layer of cream all over. You can see. Now on top of this we are just going to place our next layer of cake and again we are going to follow the same procedure, the sugar syrup, the crush and cream. Likewise we will prepare all the layers. Here is our topmost layer and to this also we are going to soak with some sugar syrup. So that our cake will be moist enough from all sides. Now one more technique I'll show you to frost the cake. This is the piping bag and I haven't added any nozzle to it. And now we are just going to apply cream on the surface, top surface. For this method you can also check my red velvet cake recipe, the video. This is the easy way of frosting your cake. And also apply on the sides. So it will be easy for us to frost. We will just take our spatula and just turn our turntable. And you can see you'll get a nice plain surface. You can see here we have got a nice plain surface and also the sides are covered. And here are few lines which can be seen, but that is completely perfect because we are going to do some design on top, so it will automatically get covered. And since we are going to make a Doraemon design, we need a flat surface. Now for 15 to 20 minutes we are going to keep this cake in fridge so that it will set properly. After 20 minutes our cake is set properly and we have taken it out from refrigerator. And now what we are going to do is, since I want to make a Doraemon cake, I'm just going to carve a design, or just a rough design of Doraemon, the eyes and the face, with the skewer, or you can also make it with the help of toothpick. First we'll make the eyes. Then the face. You can see here we have carved the outline, the eyes, the face, and now we are just going to make outline. The same carving, on top of that we are going to make lines with the help of chocolate ganache. We will take our chocolate ganache and we will pipe on the outline which we made now. You can see here we have completed the sketch, the outline, and now we are just going to fill the portions, the empty portions here, with a color cream. You can see here I have filled one piping bag and here I added star nozzle, the small one, and now I am going to pipe this white cream near the face and the eyes. You can see here we have filled it with white. Now here we are going to fill it with red, the nose and the mouth, and here orange and orange and yellow. You can see here we have completed the face, the eyes, nose, mouth, and only the blue color is left, and now we are just going to cover this completely with blue color. You can see here we have a blue color ready, and I am going to add this to my piping bag. Now we will start piping our blue color. We have covered the top and now we will just cover this also completely with blue. It will take some time. You can see here we have completely filled all the sides, top, bottom, sides, everything with the cream, and our cake is ready. And now we will keep this in fridge for half an hour to 1 hour so that it will set completely. Our yummy pineapple flavored pastry cake is ready and we have made for kids, which is in Doraemon design.